Media Uncensored. Have you subscribed to my channel? Hit the subscribe button, and also there's a notification bell, and what that does is allows you to know when I drop a new video. Yeah, thank you so much to the growing community, the already existing subscribers. Mwah, mwah. As a fashion enthusiast, as somebody who loves fashion, thank you very much. I decided, you know what, how about I do a review of the red carpet? Yeah, it's only natural, right? So I'm going to kick off with the 90th Academy Awards, aka the Oscars. This year's Oscars was filled with, in terms of fashion, we had more neutral blush tones and whites. A little bit of pop of color here and there. I wonder why. Like, it was just highly represented by those colors. And all the crazy stuff that happened, like Tiffany Haddish's dress, and I mean the dress that she keeps wearing. Like, that woman is just crazy. Nicole Kidman's major comeback. Yeah. Yes. Or Viola Davis' excellent representation of color on every red carpet. Legendary Rita Monero rocking the same dress she wore the night she won her Oscar in 1962 in 2018. Major. So, are you ready to enjoy this view? I think I need some tea or some coffee or some wine. So let's start off with Gal Gadot, our very own Wonder Woman. Her hair, her makeup, her skin, 100%. Even though, you know, she wore something that was really sparkly. I mean, from her jewelry, I heard that jewelry cost like $538,000. Like, oh my God, Tiffany's. Buys these things. So the makeup was subtle and minimal, and then she had like a bold lip, so that just made it perfect. Dania Gurira, popularly known as Okoye, the leader of the Dora Milaje of Wakanda. Man, that girl is stunning. First of all, her hair. Apparently, her hair, she had been planning it with her hairstylist, Scott, who's very, very famous. He's worked with, like, he works with celebrities like Amber Rose, Kanye West, Teyana Taylor. And look at them, Zayn Malik. Go and see all of them. Their hair is always lit. So you're just breaking into the industry. It's like what Lupita did. When you want to come out on that red carpet, you have to give them something that's memorable. And that's what Dania did. Her makeup was beautiful. She was nicely bronzed out. And I like that it wasn't too much. Jane Fonda. That woman is actually 80 years old. Her signature hairstyle was perfect for her look. I love the muted tones on her skin. Her skin looked healthy, it looked lush. It looked like she had been drinking enough water and minding her business. Taraji P. Henson, Omorobi Custard, you're not a bastard. No. Her look was really, really, really lovely. I mean, Taraji, everyone knows Taraji with her high brows. But let me talk about her hair for a second. Her hairstylist gave her like a 60s inspired bob. That was a wig. Line, the way it was cut, the way it sat on her face, the angle, it was beautiful. I love that violet lip that she was giving. I love the blush. I love how she looked. You know, Taraji has very strong features, and there's that high possibility of missing it when it comes to how she looks. So I have to give it to her. This time, her hair, makeup artist, they went very easy. They, you know, put some lashes on. I loved it. I loved the way her hair was moving. For hair and beauty and skin, I give it to Taraji, it was beautiful. Saoirse Ronan, oh my gosh. Whew, one of the most beautiful looks of the night. Love that shortcut, the color, then the makeup. Like, I like what they did around my eyes, that peachy blush on the upper part of the eyes and her lower lids, the lip. Everything was just soft. She's just like new bread, you know. Zendaya's look was lovely. I love the top bun. I love the soft, what's it called? The soft smoky eyes, you know, her brows always full. You know, her skin looked healthy. She looked radiant. She was glowing. She looked absolutely stunning. And I mean, Official Chic, who does Nikki's makeup, I mean, she does a fantastic job. She's really good with like soft, nude, easy breezy makeup. So that look was actually one of my best. Emma Stone with the asymmetric bob, it was beautiful. I love that bob. I love the length of the bob. I love the color of the bob against her her outfit, you know, and I just love like how her makeup is just understated. She looks fresh. Last year she won an Oscar, so you know, she just said, you know, let me just take it easy this year. Messy brows, you know, minimal jewelry, a great smile to complement it. I think for me what got me with that look was the hair, how the hair just kept movement of the hair. Very important to know, hair is very important. That hair looks so beautiful all the time. Matthew McConaughey, he wore a black velvet tuxedo, burgundy tie, Christian Louboutin velvet shoes. It was easy breezy, and there's just something about him that it's just the way he carries his look that he makes it look so effortless. To be, come on, I mean, not only is he good looking, but clothes sit very well on him. He was just wearing like a Giorgio Armani tux, and he just looked very clean, you know. I think for me, for a man, it's either you just look like super clean or you want to just like be a little edgy with your style. I loved what Miguel wore. Miguel was looking like grilled prawns. It was just looking edible. And he still now threw over a blazer just to say, okay, because people say we should wear velvet, okay, let me just wear it. Like, you know, and then the way he just threw it on, like, it's not even there. Like, His swag was on another level. Like, I loved it. It looked so easy breezy. I always like to see men look like they aren't even trying too hard. He didn't have that normal sharp tuxedo look, but he just had that edgy fashion forward look to his looks. My next best male would be the man of the moment, Black Panther. Wakanda! What Chadwick Boseman wore, he was wearing Givenchy haute couture. Like, this is what I'm saying about my men. If you're not gonna go on a three-piece suit or a tuxedo or go like the clean expected look, if you want to add some edge to it, you need to take lessons from Chadwick. I like what he wore to the premiere of Black Panther as well. I think he has his own sense of style, and that's a good thing because he's, you know, he's getting into this whole fame and everything, and you can actually identify him already. I can actually say Chadwick has a style of his own. Talk about Jane Fonda, 80-year-old, destroying the red carpet, allowing those small girls to just be looking at me. Look, that woman did not come to play. She was wearing a column dress by Balmain. You know, her hair, as the neckline of the dress, her look was perfect. The cut on her body, her silhouette, everything was beautiful. Nicole Kidman in Armani Privé, that dress, the bow, the way it covered, the way the dress sat, the color. What color is that? Blue. Like royal blue. That color was, ew. That color is not for children. Beautiful. And here, this time, her skin was, of course, the contrast of the color on her skin. Perfection. I mean, she even knew the way she was walking, the way she was greeting people, you would know that she was happy. You know, when you dress well, there's the way you just be greeting everyone. I loved it. I thought she just nailed that look. She was so graceful on every angle that the photographers were taking her picture. It was beautiful. The fabric looked rich. It looked like there was a lot of attention that was paid to detail. That's definitely one of my best looks of the night. Emma Stone in Louis Vuitton. Emma did not win an Oscar. She won an Oscar last year. I mean, she came to have fun at the Oscars. You know what I like, what I think should be the perfect Oscar dress? Something that is memorable. Come there with something, you know. There are many dresses that you could have worn that are just like red carpet worthy, but when you put a little edge to your outfit, that's exactly what Emma did with Louis Vuitton. I love the fact that it's burgundy or maroon, one of those colors mixed with pink. So the blazer was maroon and then she had the pink bow on it. Like, who does that? And it came out so beautiful with the peg trousers and the heels and the hair and everything. It was just different, you know. It's the kind of thing that I would do. And of course, blazers are so in, so it was just right on trend. Dania Gurira, one of my favorites and best for the nights. She came to scatter anybody. It was like, yala ya anybody, let's go. Who is coming? Let's go. You know, and even in Black Panther, she's always like, you know, like she, her body, the way her body sat in that dress. It's not anybody that can pull off that dress. I can tell you that for free. It was perfect. And she was so graceful in it. She was confident. Because confidence also adds to it. Sometimes you can wear a good dress and you're not confident enough to pull it off. She pulled it off with her low cut, the signature hairstyle, the color on her skin, beautiful. You would think for darker tones, you want to go with more color like Viola, but no. That particular color on her, the neutral tone, it was perfect. The angles at which she took the pictures as well, you can tell that from every side, my girl was covered. That is how to dress when you know that you're going to see your enemies. When they see you, they'll be blind, you know? And you're not trying too hard. It's not that to me. It's not by wearing gold and shining over the place. See how she, very classy. Viola Davis was wearing Michael Kors. I love the color, but I just don't like the fit. It just made her look straight. The bust area, you know, it was full, but it just didn't sit right, in my opinion. I love the color. I love the whole monotone. You know, I talked about it, like, there was a couple of actresses had the whole, the same color of dress, the same color of bag, then going to like a monotone look. But I just didn't like how the dress was on her body. You know, I wanted something that could show her curves a little more. I mean, she's worn other dresses and she actually looks like she's really curvaceous. This just made her look straight as a ruler. I liked it from here to the torso. After that, I just didn't feel that dress on Lupita. I think that she could have worn something else. I really like the structure of, I don't know if it's a fabric, it just looks somehow at the bottom. I mean, Atelier Versace, she's like, you know, a good brand, but sometimes it's a hit or miss, you know. And the same thing I felt about Mary J. Blige, even though the dress was perfect, I think that that hair to that dress for Mary J. Blige was a definite no. There's no way, as in, Mary has had better hairstyles than that. Now you give her that afro on that kind of dress. It was too edgy for the dress. Taraji's dress was nice, but I just didn't like it for the Oscars. It could have been for another event, but not the Oscars, you know? Her stylist was saying that, you know, everything was last minute, so I want to just say maybe that's why. Because if you look at Taraji at the 2017 Oscars and look at Taraji today, no. It was like a downgrade. No doubt. Like, I didn't like the fact that I could see the nude bust parts. I didn't like I could see the nude bust parts showing through the outfit. It was open on the chest. It was open everywhere, and it wasn't. You know, there's a way that, you know, your dress is open and it's just like sultry and sexy, but it was just too much for the Oscars. I think she had a better look in 2017, but definitely her hair and makeup was on point. But that dress, Mahershala Ali, he came to the Oscars with his wife and she was wearing some, like, that outfit, there's so much going on, the parrot, or is it the parrots that's there, the detail on the side, the detail on the body, there's even still beads on the hand, like, choose one. Pick a struggle. Pick the... You could have just put the parrots and left any other thing there. Andrea Dre is so cute. But what was that on her hair? Like, is she 5? What was all that? Okay. Salma Hayek is so beautiful. I just don't know why she gets the wrong clothes. That Gucci dress was a no-no for me. The sequin, the color, the embellishment. It was just a lot that was going on. It just felt like 1/5 Taylor. Like 1/5 Taylor, like it was not even 1/5 Taylor self, just jamming everything together. You know, then what's the problem? And last year, I even complained about her look last year, but I even think last year was even better, even though it wasn't appropriate for the Oscars. So I feel like Salma is like a new stylist.
Wakanda, Black Panther. Wakanda, Black Panther.
If you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up, please. And of course, subscribe to my channel. I'm gonna see you in my next video. I can't wait to see you guys next time.
What kind of?